गुड डे फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ अल्ताफ जहांगीर, अ टीचर ऑफ इंग्लिश फ्रॉम बेलगाम. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर विद यू अ कपल ऑफ स्पेशल केसेस रिलेटेड टू रिपोर्टेड स्पीच, रिलेटेड टू डायरेक्ट एंड इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच. वी हैव रेड एंड स्टडीड अ लॉट अबाउट डायरेक्ट एंड इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच. अ गुड नंबर ऑफ वीडियोज़ आर अवेलेबल्स एंड lots of information is available related to this topic, but today I felt like sharing a couple of special cases and exceptional cases into direct and indirect speech. When we are reporting something in spoken English, whether the change of tense is going to happen or not, when there is a wish in a direct speech, whether the tense is going to be changed or not, and a couple of adverbials like day after tomorrow and the day before yesterday, how to change them, and there are many more issues. They are not only issues, but they are special and exceptional cases related to report speech that I am going to share with you today. Good day friends. You might have seen a good number of videos on reported speech or direct and indirect speech as well. But today my agenda or my intention is to bring forward a couple of exceptional cases in reported speech. But before we start, let us discuss why do we speak in direct speech and why do we speak in indirect speech. We speak in direct speech, we use direct speech when we want to give a dramatic effect to our speech. And when do we find, or where do we find direct speech? Direct speech usually we do find in dramas, plays, you know, and in conversations, in stories as well. Fine. So direct speech is found in dramas and conversations and stories. And where do we find indirect speech, or when do we use indirect speech? We use indirect speech to report the actual words of the speakers. Fine. So this is something about direct speech and indirect speech. Now let us see a couple of special cases, or to put in better words, a couple of exceptional cases in direct or indirect speech. Now, when reporting speech is in present tense, or it is in present continuous tense, or it is in present perfect tense, or it is in simple future tense, reporting speech, when it is in present, present continuous, present perfect, or simple future tense, then the tense of the reported speech is not going to be changed. Now, you can have the examples over here. Look at this example, or let me see, take you to the explanations once again. When the reporting speech is in present tense, present continuous, present perfect, or future tense, the tense of the reported speech and some adverbials are not going to change. Adverbials related to the time. Fine. Now see here. She has said he will arrive tomorrow. Now she has said the reporting speech is in present perfect tense. He will arrive tomorrow. Now, tomorrow is an adverbial of time. This is a reported speech. She has said, it is a reporting speech, and he will arrive tomorrow, it is a reported speech. Look what is happening in answer over here. She has said that he will arrive tomorrow. Now, what change did not occur? If the reporting speech was in past tense, then the answer would have been like this. You know, she said he will arrive tomorrow, and when you change following the regular rules and principles of indirect speech, the answer will be she said that he would arrive tomorrow. But because in this particular special case the reporting speech is in present perfect tense, so the tense of the reported speech is not going to be changed, and tomorrow, usually, as per the rules of direct and indirect speech, tomorrow will be changed into the next day. But here it is not changed. Look at the answer. She had said that he would arrive he will arrive tomorrow. What is not changed? The will is not changed. The tense of the reported speech is in future tense. It is not changed. It remained the same. And the adverbial of time, tomorrow, remains tomorrow. So this is one special case related to direct and indirect speech. That is, when the reporting speech is in present, present continuous, present perfect, or future tense, the tense of the reported speech and some adverbials are not going to be changed. Friends, now we are going to discuss the second exceptional case in reported speech, or second special case in direct and indirect speech. Before I begin, let me bring to your notice one quote which I read about English grammar or transformation of sentences, that nothing expect exactness in grammar. Nothing expect exactness in grammar. If you do so, be ready to be mad. I'm telling this because my second exceptional case today is, that is, while transforming from direct to indirect speech, when it, in case of a spoken English, I'm not talking about a written English, in case of a spoken English, some of the change of the tenses sound very awkward. Now look at this example. That is, the example is, Ravi said, when I reached home, my wife was having tea. Fine. Look at this example. Ravi said, when I reached home, my wife was having tea. Now, as per the rule, what are we going to do? That when I reached home, simple past tense, it would be changed into past perfect tense. Okay. And my wife was having tea, past continuous tense, would be changed into past perfect continuous tense. That would be a written response for that. As per the principles of reported speech, this is the way we are going to change. Look at this. Ravi said that when he had reached home, his wife had been having tea. But look at how does it sound in a spoken English. If you are reporting to any of your friend like this, that Ravi said that when he had reached home, his wife had been having tea. In case of a spoken English, it sounds very awkward. So, in case of a spoken English, let us not change the tense of the reported speech so that your speech sounds better and your speech doesn't sound awkward. For example, in this particular example, Ravi said that when he reached home, his wife was having tea, and this is what usually we do say in our day-to-day life. Now, the next case is that if the condition described in past tense remains the same at the time of reporting, the tense remains unchanged in the main clause. The condition, the situation which you are describing or which you are reporting, if it remains the same at the time of reporting also, then there is no question of changing the tense. Look at this particular example. He explained, I did not buy the car because it was second hand. Now, when you want to report the same to somebody else, and at the time of reporting, even if the condition of the car is same, there is no meaning in changing the tense of the reported speech. That's why, look at this. He explained that he did not buy the car because it was second hand. When you are reporting, at the time of reporting, the car is in the same condition. I mean, the car is in used condition. The car is second hand. So the situation, the condition of the car has not changed. So there is no question of changing the tense because the situation, the condition is same. That's why. So he explained that he did not buy the car because it was second hand. As per the rule, we change the simple past into past perfect tense and all. So only the bottom line is this much, that while reporting, if the condition, if the situation Friends, now the next issue in reported speech that I would like to share with you is the change of adverbials. Change of adverbials related to time and change of adverbs related to place. We are quite aware of them. The adverbials which show the nearness of time and place in reported speech, those would be converted into the distance of the time or the place. Now, there are a couple of special adverbials which show time or place, and we need to see how we are going to change them. Look at this particular change in some adverbials. Now, we know how to change tomorrow. Tomorrow would be changed into the next day, but when it comes to the day after tomorrow, the day after tomorrow would be changed into in 2 days time. No, in 2 days time. The day after tomorrow would be changed into in 2 days time. And the next adverbial is the day before yesterday. The day before yesterday would be changed into 2 days before. This usually we don't find in most of the cases, so we need to be aware of that. Now we are going to look at a couple of more changes. Let's continue. Now two more adverbials that are going to be changed are in this way. Next day will be changed into the following day. Now usually tomorrow is changed into the next day. What in case if the next day appears in reporting speech? The next day will be converted into the following day. And the last one is, the last adverbial that I'm going to discuss right now is the last week. Last week would be changed into the previous week. But especially in this this particular session is about the change of day before yesterday and the day after tomorrow that we discussed just now. And the last special case related to reported speech is this, that if the speech is made and reported on the same day, if the speech is made and it is also reported on the same day, time changes are not made. Time is not going to change because the speech is also made on the same day and it is reported on the same day. Look at this example, friend. That is, he said this morning, I'm very busy today. He said this morning, I'm very busy today. Suppose that the speaker said this at 8 o'clock in the morning, and in the afternoon at 2 o'clock, you are reporting. The speech was made at 8 o'clock on Monday, and that same speech is reported at 2 o'clock on Monday, then how are going to be the changes? Now look at here. He said this morning that he is very busy today. What is not changed? Today, the time adverbial is not changed into that day. Why? Because the speech and the reporting both are happening on the same day. That is why the time adverbial today is not going to be changed into that day. Usually, as per the grammar rules, today would be changed into that day. But here the speech is made on the same day and it is also reported on the same day. So time adverbial is not going to change. The last special case that we are going to discuss today is if the place of statement and that of the reporting is the same, then the adverb here and a couple of others are not going to change. Look at this, friend. If the place of statement and that of reporting, I mean the place where I'm standing right now, I'm speaking and I'm reporting from the same place, in that case a couple of adverbials are not going to change. Probably this concept, the example will make you clear. Look at this example. Yesterday he came to this room. Yesterday he came to this room and said, I shall be again here tomorrow. Now this was said yesterday. You know, yesterday he came to this room and said, I shall be again here tomorrow. Now look at the reported speech. Yesterday he came to this room and said that he would be again here today. Now what are the changes here? That here place adverbial is not changed into there. Here is not changed into there. Here remains same because the place of the statement and reporting is the same, and at the same time tomorrow is changed into today. In as per the grammar rules, tomorrow would be changed into the next day. But here it is not changed. The tomorrow which you are referring is today itself. So that is why tomorrow becomes today, because the place of the statement and reporting is the same, and here remains same because the place of the reporting as well as of the speaking is same. So these were a couple of special cases related to reported speech. Hope I could reach you out. Thanks a lot for this wonderful hearing.